Deepa. I'm a proud mom of two kids. I'm a VBAC mom. My first one is 7.5 years and the second one is almost 6 months old. So my first one was a C-section delivery and this one is a completely natural vaginal birth. So today I'm going to share both experiences, having a surgical delivery and the vaginal delivery. First one was like completely healthy and happy pregnancy. Like in first pregnancy, everyone is so excited and so happy. I conceived and all, and it went very smooth, whole 9 months. And I was given a particular due date, but my labor started maybe 4-5 days before that. I spent almost 6 to 8 hours at home, and at home only my water bag broke. So after some red discharge and all, I visited the hospital, and I remember the doctor didn't even see me. He just sent me to a room where I was lying down on the bed. I was induced medically, what I remember. Nobody told me anything what was going on, and I considered it to be the procedure because I was not aware of anything, how it should go. And then the doctor came. He just checked me once or twice. He didn't tell me anything. They put the CTG machine, they were checking, and they gave something in my hand that you just press it. I was not told when should I press it also. So I was just holding it. I remember I didn't press it for the baby, nothing. Everyone was mute. His doctor didn't talk to me at all, not even the nurse, not even my family, nobody. And I was happy, okay, it's going to be like pain-free. Because I was not knowing that how much pain it is. And I didn't realize that the pain can be manageable. So I was on the operation table. The baby came out. My father was there inside just to make sure that everything is normal. And then I was shifted to my room, where I was put on the wrong bed because it was too narrow, and my baby was on the other bed, and for 2 days I didn't feed him, I didn't hold him also because I was unable to sit, and they again put some IV, and it was so painful. People were coming inside, they were going, the room was not clean. I mean, it was like not good experience. I was not feeling happy. What I felt in my pregnancy, throughout my 9 months, I was eating, walking, everything was happening, but not exactly what I expected it to be. I was always thinking that it's going to be a very nice, beautiful thing, my baby will come out, and all happy things around. But after 5 days, I came back home. Then there was no hospital visit, there was no consultation. I was not even told that I am supposed to take iron and calcium tablets after that. And it took almost 2 years for me to recover. I went through like lots of back pain and leg pains, and I didn't understand what to do after delivery. Years for me to prepare my mind that okay, I'm gonna have the second one. It's almost 7 years because I was not ready to go through the same experience again, the same trauma. So when I conceived, I was like about to terminate. I said, I don't want to go through that. Don't do that. So after that, from my cousin, I came to know that, okay, this natural birth center is something. And I thought to visit you once at least. Till that time, I was not sure that I'm going to continue. But still we came, and it was so beautiful. You explained it so well that, okay, this is natural. This is beautiful. First time I came to know, birth can be beautiful also, because it was like a ugly thing for me what happened with me. So it was very hard for me to go through it again. And so when I met you first, it was all positive thing, and somewhere inside me it clicked that it can be nice. Somebody, some doctor can be nice with me relating to my pregnancy. So we agreed to it, me and my husband, that okay, we're going to continue, and we're going to have the second one finally. And from there it started. For every visit, I was like more and more confident. And I used to be very eager to visit the center. We used to have a monthly visit, but I was wishing to have at least 15 days visit. Because every time I was getting knowledge, I was aware of what is going on inside me, what I'm supposed to do, what I'm not supposed to do. And what you told me is this is not something called, this is not a disease. This is very natural, and woman's body has the power to tolerate it and to accept it as your natural routine, and I can follow all my normal things what I used to do with little care. Yeah, when you're like around your family, you always feel that sense of security, that love, which I got from healthy mother also. It's not because we have a nuclear family, and this was like a second family for me, who were like, at any point if I give a call or anything, they will entertain me, they'll answer my questions, and they'll clear my doubt. Though I was having first pregnancy experience, I was completely blank for the second one, because that was a total different experience. This was helping me from inside. Okay, you are there, family is there. So I was so comfortable, and I didn't feel any bad thing from inside that why am I doing this. I never felt that. So I was so happy surrounded by people, and most of my son was very happy to have his baby, because he said it's his baby. Fine, so I was not worried. My caretaker was not worried. It's going well and we can do it. Then 3 days went like that. I was coming, going, and it was like okay for me. I was not worried at all, really. I was not worried. And then I was given some castor oil that was whack. But it didn't work that much. Then I was given some homeopaths and herbs, which started working a bit. And my contraction picked up. My care provider was 100% with me throughout days and night. You were with me. So, and we were talking a lot in between contractions. I was pretty fine. And some point of time I was enjoying that labor, those contractions. I was very happy. And my husband was jumping, oh, you're getting contractions. He was. My contraction picked up. They were pretty rhythmic. And finally, on 19th, I delivered at night. That was like, there also I gave up, and my care provider, she was like, no, you can do it. I was, nahi, I cannot do it, I'm not that courageous. And he's like, no, you can do it. You were continuously boosting me up that it's done, it's almost done, you're at the end. And finally he came out. He came out so beautifully, and it was unbelievable for me when that skin to skin contact happened. Before that, I was shivering, and immediately when he took the feed, I was completely normal, and it was not more than a miracle for me. Mm-hmm.